Good morning, viewers. Today we have Mr. Ankur Baid, CEO, Concord Biotech. Welcome, Mr. Baid, to our show, Plan or Perish.
Thank you.
So please share the journey of Concord, how Concord began.
So Concord, started in the year 2000. And our prime focus was that we wanted to make products through the biotech route. And till date, all the products that we are manufacturing are through the biotech process. When we started, it was a loss-making company with, and we had just three people. And now, in the span of 20 years, we have close to around 1,500 people are working with us. We have three manufacturing facilities, all having global regulatory approvals, and Concord has created a niche for itself. So we focused on our expertise, which was the biotechnology process. Just to give you the capabilities that we've built over the years, we have two manufacturing facilities. One is the API facility, and the other is finished formulation facility. And the API facility is approved by all global regulatory agencies like the US, Europe, Korea, Japan. So we have global approvals to sell our products globally. We are manufacturing products in the therapeutic classes like immunosuppressants, where we are the only company in the world which makes the entire range of immunosuppressants. And then products like oncology, anti-infectives, antifungal. For most of the products, we are market leaders. So after the innovators, we hold the maximum market share globally. So that's our strength, quality combined with a good aggressive costing proposal, cost proposal, so that we can get the market share that we are intending to go with. The other site, as I said, is the finished formulation site, which is again approved by US and other regulatory agencies. We have filed several of our dossiers in regulated markets and around the world. And now we are also coming up with a third site, which is again a fermentation site, which is going to be ready by mid of this year. And it is going to be the world's largest biotech facility, spread over 150 acres. And again, it's going to be as per global standards. So that's where our journey has been since the inception of 2000.
Seems magical, Mr. Baid.
Thank you.
From three people company to 1500 in 20 years.
Yes, yes.
Oh, that's awesome. I'm sure this story is going to be so inspirational to my readers. Tell some. Can you share some information on the financials as well?
So we've been growing since last few years. We've been growing at a CAGR growth of close to around 25%, and this year I think we'll cross over 500 crores. We have a healthy EBITDA of close to around 50%, we are a zero debt company. So all the growth that has happened in the organization has happened through internal accruals.
Oh, again, very inspirational numbers. So how many countries you are exporting right now?
Around across the globe. So so maybe like 60-70 countries, if I would have to say that.
So how do you, what points you keep in mind before expanding to a new territory? What are your checkpoints?
So I think when you enter into a new territory, or during the times when we were looking at entering into a new territory, I think the main focus was to understand the regulatory status, what the Ministry of Health of those countries are requiring, are there any specific quality requirements that they have, how the market dynamics were playing out in those territories, and how we have to build our market positioning in those markets, because there would have been some players already in those markets. So pricing yourselves in those markets, and at the same time creating a position for yourself so that, you know, the acceptance of Concord is there when we go into those markets. So those are the things I would say that regulatory hurdles, market dynamics are a few things that, you know, we would have to look at when we enter into those markets.
So as you are expanding your range of products, and so can you tell me what's your secret there? How do you pick right products and right segments? What's the strategy behind? Because whatever you're doing, everything is growing. So you must have a touch of gold somewhere.
Just to give you a few things is that what we look at is that it has to be a biotech product, because that's where our core competency is. We don't get into chemical synthesis products. We look for more complexity in the product, because you know, we would want to avoid all the competition that comes from China and all. So we want to create that niche complexity for us in terms of the molecules that we select, so that the life cycle of the product is long. And then
ensure there are entry barriers.
There are entry barriers. Actually, fermentation or biotechnology, that itself is an entry barrier, because as I said, that globally not many companies are doing that. Mm-hmm. And over and above, if you have entry barriers like complexity on the molecule, you know, that kind of adds on to your positioning when you're looking at world markets. And the players that we compete with are primarily European or Southeast Asian players, where the processing cost is much higher. So what Concord is able to offer is high quality products at an affordable pricing, and that's why I think with clubbed with our regulatory approvals that we have globally, that's why we've been able to you know, have the market share that we currently have for most of our products.
So how do you assess the profitability of a product, Ankur? So what is the, how do you know that? Because product may be selling at X price and your costing could be maybe just 1/10 of that. So how do you assess the profitability? How do you price it?
So I think that's where market intelligence comes in. You know, you know, we've been able to understand what the existing competition is, and you know, how we need to price our products. It's not that, you know, we price it at par with what the other companies are offering. I think that's where we go a little aggressive, because the aim is, you know, you need to have a good balance between volumes and value. And when I say that we have close to around 60% or 70% of the world market share for some of our molecules, you have to go aggressive. So, but it is equally important for you to understand what is the pricing which others are offering, so that, you know, with your quality, you can also support them on the price that your customers are looking at.
Share, what is your strategy? How you have been able to compete with old, established, global pharmaceutical leaders?
I think it's a matter of pricing your product at the correctly, having the right market intelligence, and going aggressively to your customers, offering them a basket of products, so that if I'm competing with one company for a product, and you know, our customer is looking at adding an entire basket of products, you know, they don't have to go to six players, they can always come to Concord, saying that, you know, you. So I think it cuts down on the supplier management also significantly. And I think if all the three things are right, the right price, the right quality, and it cuts down on all these vendor supplier issues, I think that's some of the things that most of the companies would look at. And, you know, that's how we have been able to compete and create a position for ourselves in the market.
It's been wonderful interacting with you, Ankur.
It was my pleasure.
And I am so amazed with the kind of clarity you have, and I'm sure you will take the company to very great heights.
Thank you.
All the best to you. Thank you so much.
It was a pleasure talking to you. Take care. Thank you.
Thank you.